Michael Bevan had to go. And he's given. Well, I think that's probably out. Yes, he's given. Yes, ran to the wicketkeeper that time. And desperately stretching out. And eventually lost his bat. An umpire done at square leg was given his second run out.
Well, the Australians here running for everything. Normandy and Healy missed that delivery. Shane Lee, the non-striker, decided to go through with the run, but Mongia, wise to the occasion, hitting the stumps direct. 258 for 7, Australia.
So Shane Warne is the new batsman. Shane Warne with Fleming and McGrath to come. That's his track record with the bat, an average of 14. He more often than not expected to come in there and smash it around. He's out there because of this run out. The ball went straight to the wicket. It was a little leg cutter again, bounced very slowly, and it was a slow delivery, and this is a good accurate throw. Hit the middle and off, and clearly Shane Lee was out of his ground. So that was the end of him. 258 for 7. Well bowled again, story played, and hit straight to extra cover, and that is the end of that. Well, it really was a slower ball. It just popped up the moment as we did. Shane Warne just wanders off the ground. He was trying to drive it away on the offside down the ground to mid-off, I'd say, but it really was a little lollipop.
Well, this is good bowling by the Indians. Again, Venkatesh Prasad varying his pace, the slower one, and Shane Warne playing a little too early. To the safe hands of the Indian captain. Another wicket gone, 258 for 8. One has noticed as the innings has progressed and the ball has got softer, the ball really has not come onto the bat. And that's the reason why boundaries have been hard to come by.
It's well bowled too, right up in the block hole. There's nothing much you can do about those. This has been a good performance in the latter overs by India. That's a magnificent hit. He's got that one way down. Oh no, he's going to be out. Oh, he's got him, yes. For a second I thought that was going into the crowd. It went miles in the air. That's a magnificent catch down there. Hopefully coming in off the boundary underneath that very, very high hit by Healy. That's the area he loves best. He got onto it all right, but got too far underneath it.
Well, picking this lower one up and swinging it on the onside, this really is a very good catch by Anil Kumble, because the ball, he had the sun in his eyes, and in the end kept his eyes on the ball and took it cleanly. 258 for 9, Australia. So Glenn McGrath comes out into the middle, and he may not even get a chance to face a delivery because the batsman crossed over when Ian Healy got out. His job today for Australia would be to fire on all cylinders when he's bowling.
The last ball of the innings. And he's missed it. They're going to run. And it's coming down the bowler's end. And he's got it. Yes, he's out. Run out. The Australians all out. Well, that is good thinking by Mongia. Five run outs in the innings, and Mongia really realised that he wasn't going to get McGrath, and he decided to go for the bowler's end. The bowler got back to his stumps, and they managed to get the batsman run out of the non-striker's end. Five run outs in the innings.
This is good thinking by Nan Mongia. The non-striker had backed up too far, and Mongia realising that he wouldn't get out if he threw it at the striker's end, threw it to the bowler, who made no mistake in removing the bails. So five run outs for Australia, 258 all out after 20.